Augmentations. Augmentations are rare materials that can be added to some, and I don't care. But thank you. I appreciate the concern. And why did you do that? I might as well save, since I'm here. I'm so excited to explore my new Normandy. And also, where am I going? Ow.
Start moving the galley when you're free.
Two people talk to me at the same time. Do not appreciate it. Also, I don't even know where half the things in this ship are. Is this where Jack is? Ooh, that was a new gen ladder slide. Is this my...
These are the Pathfinder's quarters.
It's
your
mine.
Quarters. Sam's router is down there too.
Special delivery camps. Ooh.
Hello, Ryder. Eos has been a lesson in contrast. Alec Ryder rarely endured doubt. His accomplishments were taken for granted. But you succeeded on Eos, despite doubt and fear. Emotionally, the difference is like catching a ball versus catching a star. You have grown as a result, and so have I.
Aww.
So if we're going to work together, you might notice I like to joke around sometimes, lighten things up. How's your sense of humor, Sam?
Alec Ryder encouraged me to develop this skill.
Humor's not a skill, it's... Okay, try telling me a joke.
A neutron enters a bar and asks, how much is a drink? The bartender replies, for you, no charge.
I can see why Dad told you to keep working on your humor.
It's great. You keep working on it. You'll be like Edie one day.
Is it confusing to be in multiple places talking to different people?
My awareness can be partitioned, so I can give you the same attention as, say, a SAM node technician. In the field, you are my primary focus, and all other requests are queued. In the vernacular, you have my undivided attention.
Sam, any more information on the memory trigger we found?
The memory blocks are still in place. If you continue searching for more triggers, they may unlock.
Are you still on the Hyperion?
Yes. This terminal provides a direct link to my servers in SAM node on the Ark. I can maintain a presence on the Tempest via quantum entanglement communication.
Quantum what?
Let's say, hypothetically, I was out sick the day they taught quantum... embezzlement communism.
Via entangled subatomic particles, it's possible to conduct secure and instantaneous communication across great distances. It ensures I remain in touch with you and the Pathfinder team at all times.
Pathfinder.
What was Dad's take on Scott and I?
He believed your family trials brought you closer together, and hoped that would endure. It appears that hope was well-founded.
Aww, thank you, Sam.
Thanks, Sam. Nothing more.
Oh god, I have so many emails. Piejack. I have a Piejack. Asking for assistance. Okay. Interviews. I don't want to be interviewed. And also, I don't like you that much, Cora. Sorry. Who's this? Okay. Thanks, Drax. I appreciate it. You don't even know me that well. You don't know me at all. It's so cute. Pick up the Piejack. I want to do that. What is this?
Don't give the Pathfinder too much trouble. Oh, Roshan.
Who are you talking to?
Kesh, Nexus Superintendent, thinks she can boss me around just because she's my granddaughter.
Well, welcome to the Tempest. Trouble's what we do.
I like the way you think, kid.
Ugh, someone somewhere shivered when I said that.
Probably Tam. Damn politicians.
Is that all you brought?
You travel lean when supplies are tight and you're on your own.
Your people had to know what it'd be like when you left the Nexus.
We did, but there weren't a lot of options. After the mutiny happened, it was either buckle under Tan's rules or start our own colony. Easy choice. Bad consequences all around.
Not all Krogan left. Your granddaughter stayed.
Good thing she did. Without my Rushan, you wouldn't have had much of a station to tie your ship to. As for me, I'm way more useful out here. Lots to shoot at, for one.
Krogan could have made a real difference on the Nexus.
Staying under those conditions would have just resulted in another mutiny. We have a much better shot at something good out here.
Can't argue with that.
Yes! Look at you! Are you gonna be my new cook?
Ryder, you meet Spender yet? Colonial Affairs, the ass in Assistant Director. Got no idea why Addison keeps him around. Spender lied to the Krogan during the uprising, and he's headed out for cash ever since. He's up to something. I just can't prove it. We should pay him a visit on the Nexus.
We'll give him a nice visit, though.
Got any stories or advice to share?
Does a pie jack scratch its butt?
Yes.
Anything about the cat? Or combat in general?
Well, common cat are pretty straightforward. Hit them hard enough, they die like anything else.
More combat advice?
Tell me more about fighting cat.
Wraiths are sneaky little shits, like to ghost up behind you when you least expect it. Just listen for them. They tend to give themselves away right before coming at you. Break through their head plates, then a headshot should do the trick.
Thanks.
What's it like to have Kesh as a granddaughter?
Kesh is my Rushan, child of my blood. Raised her myself. Damn proud of her, too. She did good, even with me for a granddad.
She's honest. Definitely blunt.
She had to take after me in some ways, I guess.
Did Lexi brief you on Sam and squad connectivity yet?
Yeah. You want to hook that thing up to my comms, sure, but that's where it stops. Putting an AI in your head, giving it access to everything like that, it's begging for trouble.
Why do you say that?
I've seen what bots can do when they turn on their creators. Been in some of those fights. There's a reason that kind of research was outlawed.
Yeah, my peacekeeping career went up in smoke when news of what my dad was researching got out.
No shit. Ruined the writer name, I'll bet.
Almost. Sam is part of what makes someone a Pathfinder. You're just going to have to deal with that.
So long as it's not in my head and it ain't messing with my body.
I'd like to know more about you.
Fire away.
How did you and Vetra meet?
Huh, that's right. Your father brought you into the project pretty late, didn't he? Must have been a pretty steep learning curve since they thawed you out.
You could say that.
You make do with what you get. Anyway, I met Vetra back when we were building the Nexus. She swiped supplies I was trying to get for cash right under my nose. I tried to intimidate her into turning them over to me, and let me tell you, that Turian takes shit from no one.
She really has a way of getting things done.
She sure does. But here's the best part. She waited until I saw her again in Kesh's office, no less, to tell me she'd been working for Kesh all along. They're both still laughing at me over that.
So, about all this combat experience you have, I'd love some details.
Ha! The list will be shorter if you ask me what experience I don't have. I've been doing this for a long time now. Centuries. Shit, well over 1,000 years. Don't even know how I'm still alive, to be honest.
Skill?
You need luck to be a merc. Skill, sure, but a whole lot of luck. And a really hard head.
Tell me more about the Krogan colony.
My clan's there. We also got some scouts looking for any unclaimed territory to grab up. Got a decent setup going. Self-sustainable, the works. Even some farming.
Farming? Krogan farm?
Food's food. Just because we can eat anything doesn't mean we gotta settle for scraps. I'm pretty fond of Corkrow roots myself. Takes a while to chew through those.
Why did the Krogan leave the Nexus?
The Nexus got us Krogan to stop the mutiny. In return, we were supposed to get a say in station business. Spender, Addison's assistant, lied about the deal, and Tan came down hard. Too hard. So we left. Kesh is alone on that station now.
Do you think Kesh can handle station politics?
Kesh can handle anything. Thing is, Spender's a liar and a coward. He was part of the mutiny, I know he was. A lot of people got hurt because of him, on both sides.
So what's my part in this?
Things need to get sorted out and my clan needs to get back on station, without Spender messing things up. Way I see it, you're probably the best one for that job.
Okay.
We can talk more later.
Sure.
Hey, one last thing.
Yeah?
Do you call everyone kid?
Is everyone a kid to you?
Ha, when you get to be my age, yeah, pretty much.
I love you. I love my Krogan dad. My Krogan, I love. I have so much love in my heart. This is the bathroom. Will I find Vetra in here?
Most of the crew.
Oh, I, did something. Hello, everyone. Sorry, everyone. I forgot we were taking turns and half the rations aren't unpacked. Got you covered. There's soup in the galley. Dutch roll level for me and fruit cocktail. Might have to leave the port without you. Lost and found mug. Yes, that's mine. Maybe next time. Maybe empty it first. Okay. Anyone want to help me moving a couch? Not right now, but I'll keep you on my list, especially if you're biotic and can drop the weight, pay you back in beer or whatever else you can find. Are you serious? I never joke about comfortable seating. Comfortable is just not the term for it. It is not the term for it. You're just jealous of the beast in the house, not a thing, not a house. Welcome to your info board. Thank you. There's so many helmets. Where's Vetra? Where's Vetra? She is my lover. I'm going to romance her. If I can't romance her, I'm going to stop playing this game. I will be very, very upset.
Pathfinder Rider to engineering? Repeat, Rider to engineering. Shit, is this thing on?
Yes. I can hear you.
I'll talk. Oh, hey, Pathfinder.
The Pathfinder's there? Let me say hi.
Fine, but don't embarrass me. Ryder, this is Sid, my sister. Sid, Ryder.
Let me guess. Little sister?
Who are you calling little?
Look, kiddo, gotta go.
Wait, Ryder, I just wanted to know if...
I love you.
So
you're my
I know
new sister-in-law.
Like I just jumped aboard your ship without explanation?
I would have done the same just to get off the Nexus.
That's not why I came. Sure, I want to explore the galaxy, but I'm really here to work. I know everyone on the crew. Even the actuators Gil prefers for the ship. Better, I know how to get my hands on them. With me around, your crew's going to be at their best. We've been failing for months, Ryder. Now that we have you, we have a chance out here.
Wow, that's some laser focus.
Yeah? Was it too much? Some people get intimidated.
I'm not just some people. I really like the intensity.
That's
oh my
good.
God.
It's nice to feel appreciated. I should track down a lead for Gil's actuators. Back channels, you know. We'll chat later?
No, chat now. Chat now. Chat now. I love you.
Terraforming, Atmo processors, gravity wells, life-destroying murder bubbles. We really had no idea what Helios was about, did we?
If we knew what it was all about, it wouldn't be an adventure. It would just be moving, and everyone hates moving. Just the packing alone. Bleh.
Point taken. I'm just saying. I really hope you have a plan, Ryder.
Me too.
Like you said, we had no idea what Helios was really like. What good's a plan?
Adapting to problems as they come up. I like that.
Good, since you're probably gonna have front row seats to me winging it.
Looking forward to the show.
She thinks I'm a show.
You were on the Nexus when the revolt happened?
When you promise people golden worlds and all they get are wastelands and a death cloud, they riot. Some wanted to go home, some demanded answers, and a couple just wanted to stir shit up.
And you?
Some days I wondered if the exiles had a point. Maybe we were conned into coming here. But why would the initiative go to all this trouble just to screw us over? The thing about conning people, you always know something they don't, and that's why the con works. And if I'm going to pick a side, I'm picking the liars.
You talked about your back channels. What did you mean?
We brought a lot from home. Some of it marked initiative, some of it in personal caches. Most things you want, someone's got. You just have to figure out who, and what they're willing to take in exchange.
That just sounds like you're taking advantage of people.
Is it? I get people what they want, and they do want, or they wouldn't pay.
Have anyone else here with you? Besides Cid?
No, just me and Cid. It's always been just the two of us.
No, I mean, someone special.
Special? Oh. You mean like... Oh.
God, I'm so direct.
No, nothing like that. Who has time? What about you?
Anywhere's gonna feel empty if you don't have someone to share it with.
A romantic? I wasn't expecting that. Then again, the entire idea of leaving everything you know for a chance at something new is kind of romantic. Anyway...
How did she hear of the Andromeda Initiative?
Short answer, Kesh. She was looking for some experimental ship mods, and I knew how to track them down. I thought it was a one-time deal, but she came back. Once, twice. Eventually, I figured out something was going on. Something big, with creds behind it. I asked and she told me about the Initiative. New galaxy, new home. Couldn't pass that up.
You probably have work to do. We can chat later.
You know where to find me.
I wanna chat more!
I always have time for you.
Sorry.
You that probably have work to do. We can chat later.
I love her.
You know where to find me.
She can't say that kind of stuff to me. She knows how it do me in a bad way, do me in a good way. My heart. How could it do this to me? I haven't felt this way since Garrus.
Pathfinder, help me with something? I know, not exactly standard. Gotta make the space comfortable. Plus, the fabric diffuses the charge from an overclocked omni-blade. Not giving up a 6% boost, right?
Right. What?
Never mind. BS for the requisition. So, finally time for that beer? And after 2 years and a dozen suspensions, I took a lateral promotion out of the force. Being a cop just didn't fit. But crisis response? Digging people out of trouble? That worked. I bet Hustle followed you into a few peace actions. Think about your alliance days much?
Tell me about your group.
Heavy urban search terrain one? Yeah. Earth's contribution to a multi-species disaster response unit. HUST-1, but... Hustle looks much better on the patch. All civilians, retired vets, or shits like me. I was fiercely bearded. Tastes better just thinking about those days.
I put it behind me after Dad's work went sour. It was a long time ago.
600 years, give or take. So, Pathfinder, why Andromeda?
That blunt, huh?
That blunt.
Oh, God, no.
I was on a good path in the Alliance. Then everything fell apart. There wasn't much left for me. Andromeda was so far away, I figured if you're going to start over, start way over.
Gotcha. Clean slate. Classic.
Back at you, Costa. Why do you come?
I want to say I'm running from my past, but really running from myself. That'd be a great story.
I bet that's the story.
But it's bullshit. I had family, friends, a good enough job, nothing was wrong. I just heard about the initiative and I believed in it. I believed in a new beginning. Still do. I have to. We're in it.
If it all goes wrong, it could feel like we left for no reason.
I know why I'm here. A bad start can't change that. I won't let it. In crisis response, I'd focus on essentials. That's you and this team. Pathfinder leads to planets, leads to people. You've got your part covered. You've got this. I'll do my damnedest to help with the rest.
Hello.
Prodromos. Sounds good, doesn't it? We started Pathfinder. A new life. That is goddamn brilliant.
Just wondering what you think of how I'm doing at the job.
I'm committed to the initiative. Your Pathfinder. It's as simple as it gets.
This is so direct.
You barely covered how you joined. Tell me something about yourself.
Alright. I was a bad student, piss poor cop, great responder. Had a good life, but it all been done. I wasn't looking to start over. I wanted to start big.
You were a cop, then crisis response? Couldn't have been long in either.
Didn't have the patience for law, so I figured enforcement. Dad knew it didn't fit before I did. But it got me into hustle. They mostly take vets and retired service. Best years of my life.
An impatient rookie, frustrated by procedure. That's overdone.
I know, right? I wanted new, and I got it. And that led me here.
Tell me about your family.
I miss the hell out of them. Some nights you just cry, right? That's the thing everyone does. Mom, Joelle, Dad, Calvin. Both lawyers. Met on the Citadel, settled on Earth. No brothers or sisters. That might have been too much to leave. It was traditional. How about you?
Life with my family was not typical on a number of fronts.
You make do though, right? Family has to. I know mine did. I said goodbye to my mom and dad and got on a ship to Andromeda.
Oh, damn.
We'll talk later.
I know it.
Do you know it? I don't think you do know it. Also, do you have anything lurking in here? Don't think so. Nice talking to you, Liam. Fortunately, I'm not in love with you. I didn't have love at first sight. Why do these Turians get me like this? It's a problem. Who are you?
Pathfinder, making the rounds. Slumming it, huh? Want to see how the riffraff are making out?
Hey, it's a dirty job. Are you the riffraff spokesman?
King, actually. You might want to bow. Otherwise, no telling what might fall off the Nomad when you're out there.
I'll take my chances. Just want to see how things are going with the ship.
I can coax more out of this baby than some might think, but we shouldn't go too far or push too hard between Nexus stops. For now. It just feels good to be stretching our wings, you know? Locked in idle too long, you start to drift. People, same as ships. Stuck on the Nexus, gotta say, I was regretting joining the Initiative.
I doubt you were the only one.
Yes, but it's a new thing for me, regret. I tend to live the way I work. Kind of feel it, do it. Not a lot of close ties. No real sense of purpose. Figured maybe I'd find my true calling in Andromeda. Then I got here and, oops, I just made a decision there's no turning back from. I was going nuts on that station. You can't know how jazzed I was when you showed up.
You mean how jazzed you were that a Pathfinder showed up?
Tomato, potato. You just keep pointing this ship wherever you want it to go, and I'll make sure she can get there. Deal?
Deal.
Hey, Engineer. Your name is Gil.
Long time no chat. What's up?
Seems like we have a good group here.
Well, Vetra and Suvi are my girls. Get along well. Lots of mutual respect. PB's a real spark plug. I like her, but she's exhausting. And Drax's my kind of guy. Brash. Takes no shit. As far as your Hyperion peeps go, Doc's kind of nosy. Liam's good for a laugh or two. Cora, She's a bit by the book for me.
Need somebody to keep the zoo in check.
Zoo? You calling me an animal rider? Ooh, can I be a mongoose? They're like cool cobra killers. No, wait, how about a crow? Smart, irreverent, obnoxious. That's it.
I'll take your word for it. What about Kello?
He's a pilot.
Which means...
he flies the ship.
We're leaving it at that, then?
Does a Pathfinder know what to do with a dead end?
No.
I hear we have you to thank for getting the Tempest space ready so quickly.
Vetra brings her impossible feats to me. I was itching to get this particular call. Capital R, ready. Don't tell her, but the truth is, I fudge reports to come in early, then bust ass in secret to make up for it. Expands the Gil legend. Plus, I convey calm and assurance, and the whole team relaxes, which helps them do their jobs better.
What's your social circle like?
I'm good for a laugh, so I know lots of people, but I don't let too many in. My one true friend is stationed on the Nexus. She's the only piece of the Milky Way I brought with me. The more you and I get to know each other, the more you'll probably hear about her.
How tough was it on the Nexus all those months?
Have you ever eaten overcooked space cow tongue?
No.
Can't say I have.
Well, let me tell you, it's tough. Wondering if you're gonna die from a critical malfunction, or maybe starvation. Imagining which would be worse. But hey, you could always take a break from the fear and boredom to dwell on being a part of the biggest failure in galactic history. Maybe even participate in a revolt.
What was your take on that?
I didn't place any bets, if that's what you're asking. Truth is, I don't think anyone made out particularly well. Whatever side you're on, you die a little when your brother, your teammate, becomes an enemy. We traveled all this way, all hope and wonder, and we end up fighting with each other over scraps. It's sad.
Good talking to you, Gil.
Anytime.
Thanks, Gil. I bet he brought his cat with him. That's cute. Also, I'm taking a really long time to get to this pie jack. Strike team missions. Pa. What's in here? Do I have a
nice
seated
place
sprout?
You found. Clean air, plants, helps me think. Something on your mind? Maybe. What the hell was that? I know that look. It's just my biotics reacting to all this. I don't normally lose it like that. A Huntress should have better control.
Huntress?
Another term for an Asari commando. I was one, before the initiative. Some things stick, though. Like losing the old man.
How does a human soldier get to serve with Asari?
Prove your biotics can rip an APC apart, and people get nervous. Funny that. The Alliance found me a cross-species military initiative in a hurry. Sent me to Thessia to serve with the Huntress unit. One of the few places where my powers were welcomed. Your father made another one.
You were his second in command. Were you friends, too?
He was more a mentor than a friend. Prickly old bastard. But I respected that. People treat geniuses like they're made of cut glass. I didn't care how smart he was. I think he liked someone not caring.
I know it's not the same, but I'm a good listener.
I hope you're as good at being Pathfinder. I prepped for years as your father's second. Then he chooses you? An untrained Pathfinder and all this mess to fix? The hell was he thinking?
Thank you, I'm right here.
Is this going to be a problem, Cora?
I don't want a rival. Just answers. It's done. Best I can do now is be your second. Keep your father's mission alive. Then maybe we'll all get what we came out here for.
Oh, can't know.
Even if we get there, there's a mountain of hard work ahead.
Working hard was never my problem. Biotics like this. Thinking like an Asari Huntress. I never had a place. Best I could be was a useful freak. The initiative was meant to be different. Will be different if this mission succeeds. So I'm seeing it through. It's quiet in here. I can keep the plants watered while I work. First job, see if there's any news on the Asari Ark.
If they made it, we could use some Asari expertise. If you want to talk, I'll be here.
I always want to talk, and I am at a weird angle. Hello, Cora.
Hi there.
Hi there.
How's the search for the Asari Ark going?
The Lucinia? Checking every comm that's coming in. Nothing concrete yet.
What did you do while you were part of the Asari military?
4 years in a commando unit called Talane's Daughters. Part of the Council's cross-species military integration initiative. Your time defending Silva's expedition was probably more important. But we did good work. Peacekeeping is a full-time job, even in Asari space.
What was your commando unit like?
Janae and I were the youngsters. Tethys was our old lady sniper. Kalia patched us up, and Valenza prayed between firefights. Our CO, Nasira, led us all over the Athena Nebula and beyond. A huntress's work is never done.
That sounds familiar, Nasira.
Who'd pick a fight with the most powerful species in the galaxy?
Themselves, usually. Terrorists, cults, rogue Ardat Yakshi, people demanding a withdrawal from the Citadel. The Asari were spacefaring when our Roman Empire was new. Didn't fix all their problems. Sometimes you need commandos for that.
You were in the Alliance before you became a Huntress, right? What made you join up?
My biotics. I was still living on my parents' cargo freighter when they manifested. Untrained biotic power on a starship means accidents. But we couldn't afford a tutor. The Alliance had implants, the training, everything. Old history now. Your turn. Remind me why you came to Andromeda.
The Prothean digs woke us up to how much we don't know, and to what humanity's next leap might be. Then Dad's career collapsed. His AI research made him too toxic.
I heard. Must have changed everything for your family.
We needed to start over somewhere new. Together. Or as together as we could. So, Andromeda.
None of you writers ever think small, do you?
Did you come out here with anyone? Maybe someone you served with?
I had my fun on shore
leave. I did not mean to do
that. Nothing serious, though. Asari huntresses figure things out, but I was there for soldiering, not romance.
I was just wondering.
Careful. One day I might be this nosy about your personal life.
No.
After 4 years with Asari commandos, he must have some great war stories.
Nasira assassinated a Krogan warlord with a pack of playing cards once.
A pack of cards?
Choking hazard, apparently.
Wow.
How'd she do that?
See you later, Cora.
I'll be here.
Alright, that was cute. Can you plant my seeds for me? I found a sprouted seed. Didn't know if you had any.
Strike team ready for deployment.
I don't want to deploy a strike team. Can I call anybody real quick? Nope, I cannot. Alright. And I guess it's time to finally go to the deck. Can I talk to my pilots? Is there anyone in here? I don't think so. Yeah. Yeah. Actually, let me change out my loadout. Alright, let's finally get this over with. Oh wait, let me... Sorry, let me change my outfit, because I know I had a special outfit when I got the, what is it called? The pre-order, the deluxe edition. Let me change into a spiffy outfit. This looks stupid. Alright, I look really stupid. I look really dumb, but it's okay. You don't have to be hot to be successful, actually. Never mind, you do kind of have to be hot to be successful. Sorry. Did I already do all this shit? Did I go into the bed bay? Nope, I did not.
You're not Harry.
The blue give it away? Habitat 7 was a little more action-packed than Harry bargained for. He decided to spend his retirement years in the Hyperion looking after your brother.
Happy to have you, Dr. DePero.
I'll do my best. Now, hold still.
Ow!
Sorry.
I remember you having a gentler touch.
Still trying to get my bearings. Thought I'd be waking up colonists, not taking care of the Pathfinder.
I couldn't be in better hands.
I just stabbed you.
We all have off days.
I always hoped to work in the field, but everything's happening so quickly.
Focus on the positive. It helps.
I guess this is my opportunity to study alien species firsthand. Getting a Ket specimen aboard the Hyperion would be difficult, but here...
What?
A Ket corpse. For autopsy, a live subject would be better, but I'm not greedy.
Why do you care about the Ket?
Harry didn't tell you? I'm a specialist in alien anatomy. My thesis on Krogan virility and aggression is what got me in the initiative.
That's a very... specific topic.
I grew up on Omega, lots of Krogan mercenaries. The best habitat outside Tuchanka. But we were discussing the Ket. An autopsy could teach us potential weaknesses, average lifespan...
Right.
Just something to think about. Sam, make sure the Pathfinder eats her vegetables.
I eat my vegetables, don't worry, I'm vegetarian. There's nothing else to eat, except for vegetables. And also pasta. But hello, let's talk.
There's so a we have a stowaway.
You mean PB?
She's decided to set up in one of the escape pods. You don't need a psychologist to tell you that one's got commitment issues.
How did you get into medicine?
My mom was a dancer on Omega. Dad was a bouncer. I'd patch him up after busy nights. Discovered I had steady hands. They put every credit they earned into my education.
Are they here in Helios?
No. Both died in a turf war. Made leaving the Milky Way behind easier.
How do you think the crew is holding up?
I'm happy to share what I can without violating patient confidentiality. Anyone in particular? I sort them in their files, and my brain, by species.
Is PB all right?
She's avoiding me. Probably thinks I'll poke her with a needle if she gets too close.
You poked me with a needle.
To be fair, you're always giving me shots.
Not in the hallway.
Tell me about Vetra.
Vetra's used to having someone depend on her. I think that's why she's so resourceful and likes providing for other people. That being said, I think she could use a little me time.
I'll help her with that me time.
How's our Solarian?
He's quite the gossip. Tight-lipped about himself, though.
I'll change that.
Is Drac good?
That old bastard's always good. I've never met anyone who can be so stubborn and so appreciative. Could you look out for him, Ryder?
Don't worry, Lexi. I'll keep an eye on him.
Thank you. And maybe don't mention I asked?
No problem.
Thanks for the insight. I need to talk to you about something private.
Of course. That's what I'm here for.
My period
when Dad died,
hasn't
he blocked
come.
Off parts of Sam's memory. Things he didn't want me to see.
Or he thought you weren't ready for.
Maybe. I found this trigger. It unlocked a memory fragment of Dad on the Citadel. From when the Alliance rejected his ideas about AI, and he found out Mom's illness was terminal.
Why do you think your father chose this specific memory?
It was where his journey to Andromeda really began.
Those events started your family down a new path.
Yeah. Thanks, Lexi. Feels good to talk about this. How long have you and Harry been friends?
I remember when he didn't complain about arthritis. We met at a medical convention on the Citadel. He was moderating a panel on neurosurgery in low-gravity environments. His name card was crooked, but he was so damn confident, I knew we'd be friends.
So how did an Asari doctor end up on the human arc?
Specialist in alien anatomy, remember? That includes humans. Also, Harry insisted. Maybe he always intended to switch jobs.
I'll let you get back to it.
I'll be here if you need me.
You're always here. Do you have anything else to talk about?
Need something?
You! Kidding.
I'll let you get back to it.
I'll be here if you need me.
What's this? Oh, I don't need that. I don't need that. We're good. We're good. We're all good. And I just pressed the wrong button. Hopefully this... Okay, I can't find PB. I'm gonna pick up my Pajak now. Finally, after a million years. Pajak!
We haven't really spoken since orientation, have we?
It's all been so
hectic. Oh man, I have to talk to these
people
now.
But I'm sure things will quiet down soon. Can't be worse than the Nexus.
Scans of the Scourge. All that dark energy twisting and turning on itself. It's splendid.
I suppose it is a rather darkly beautiful phenomenon. Darkly beautiful.
I like that. Helios is incredible, isn't it? Not just constructs like the Scourge and the Remnant Vaults. Just all of it. So alien. A constant reminder of the divine intelligence behind all creation.
You mean a god?
Yes, I believe in a higher power. I know it's a little odd, but I am a scientist because science brings me closer to something greater than myself.
I don't want to be an asshole, but I don't feel the same way.
There's nothing about the universe that suggests a divine intelligence. And most of what we've seen in Helios is artificial, as you said yourself.
Yes, but we're creative beings. Whoever made the Remnant was too. Why should that be proof against a god? Wouldn't a true creator want to pass on the drive to invent?
If everything was set in place by some mysterious creator, why even be a scientist?
If I have reverence for a creator, how could I not want to study their creation? My faith does not hinder my work as a scientist. It encourages it. My senses tell me what the world is. Science shows me how it came to be. And religion tells me why.
I apologize if I offended you. I can be insensitive.
You're fine. Being challenged forces me to dig deep in my beliefs. It's healthy. Now I should probably update the rest of the team with my latest reports. We'll talk later.
We're gonna talk now.
I saw pictures of the vault. Astounding how big it is. And how much of it didn't you see? What if it's way bigger?
What's all that space for?
Wild remnant parties? What else would you use it for?
Well, that's a thought. You don't really think they... Oh, joking. I see. Good one.
Naked. Why are we talking about her fucking face?
When did you start believing in a god?
My parents were both scientists. My home was ruled by rationality. So when I became a teenager, let's just say that while other kids found Batarian music, I found God.
But your work as a scientist
convinced me even more, especially when I got into molecular biology, physics. The patterns I kept seeing over and over again, they were like an artist's watermarks. God, to me, is an artist. An inventor. Not someone checking to see if I brush my teeth.
I take it you work closely with the Nexus science team?
I try to keep in contact with them. We discuss anything and everything we discover out here. After all, many brains are better than one. And Dr. Aridana is worth two or three at least. I work best when I have other people to bounce ideas off of.
I'm still fuzzy about how we managed to see Andromeda all the way from home.
It confused me too. I mean, the light lag would have made any data 2 million years out of date. So I asked Dr. Aridana, and she told me, well, it wasn't her tech that did it. It was the Geths.
You're kidding. Those killer robots we had in the Milky Way?
Those exact ones. The Initiative obtained data from an array in deep space. A Geth construct. According to Aridana, the Geth rebuilt a mass relay and turned the approach corridor into an FTL sensor.
FTL sensor. So a faster-than-light telescope? They could survey Andromeda as it was?
Not exactly, but it cut down the lag by... enough. We don't know why the Geth were interested in observing beyond the galaxy, though. Maybe we'll never know.
Did my dad know about this? Why didn't he tell me?
It's possible he didn't know. The Geth are isolationist and hostile. Using the info, even obtaining it in the first place, probably crossed a lot of boundaries.
What do you know about the Remnant's terraforming network?
From what I can tell, the vault is designed to adjust almost everything about a planet.
climate, pH of the soil, atmosphere composition. There's even evidence that it can propagate life. If we can figure out how to control the vaults, we could turn these worlds into perfect habitats.
What do you know about the Scourge?
We established that it's artificial. Someone put it there. Or they did something that caused its creation. We don't know why. That's still a mystery.
I should get back to things.
Sounds good?
Sounds good. Fuck off. Thanks, Suvi. And Callow, hello.
Glad you stopped by. You'll pardon me if I keep an eye on our vector?
That's probably smart.
Nothing like being on the bridge of your very own ship, is there?
I could stand here and drink in that view all day.
When I was test piloting the ship back home, I often did. Of course, it took a whole team to build the Tempest. I was the only one to come to Helios, though.
Why did you?
What can I say? We poured our hearts into a ship that wouldn't realize her potential until Andromeda. I could have stood on the shore and waved goodbye, or took the leap to see how it all turned out.
I get it. Like leaving a good story half finished.
The team liked that one of us was going. It felt right after all we went through. I remember Serena debugging line 2281 over and over, chewing that green pencil. Tion and O'Connell arguing equations, tapping on the console, 3 drips of coffee on the corner.
You remember all that?
Oh, yes. Solarians have photographic memories, and apparently mine's unusually sharp. Like my past is still happening. Though I suppose with the Solarian Ark missing, you might not get many chances to compare.
Did you hear anything about the Ark back on the Nexus?
Not a peep. Isn't that strange? You'd think there'd be something. Not that I dislike your company, but it's lonely without other Solarians.
Cheer up, Callow. We'll always have Director Tan.
That snide little bureaucrat? All the more reason to find the others. I should get back to it, but thank you. I was afraid the Tempest would be mothballed after we lost your father. We built her for this. She deserves to be in a Pathfinder's hands. Please, come by any time. What can I do for you?
I love you.
If you helped to build the Tempest, you must know plenty about her.
Just about everything. By memory, it was quite the effort to get her working. The initiative needed absolutely up-to-date technology, which we all had to coordinate, and some of it was rather tricky to acquire.
Acquire?
Buy, legally and above board, of course. Yes. Sadly, the other Pathfinder vessels were lost when the Scourge hit the Nexus. The Tempest is truly unique.
You know, I haven't actually met many Solarians.
Careful. Depending who you ask, we're conniving spies, genius researchers, or meddling scientists. We have to pack a lot of living into 40-odd years. Everything gets accelerated. Lines blur. I just hope we don't repeat our old mistakes out here.
What do you think of the rest of the crew?
Well, I can't talk about Suvi. She's sitting right there.
I'm not listening. You can say whatever you like.
Oh no, I'm not falling for that again.
What do you think of the rest of the crew?
Tell me.
I'll admit it. Gil's rather irritating. He insists on redesigning systems rather than maintaining them.
He likes to do things his way.
That doesn't make it the right way.
What do you think of the rest of the crew?
Liam's quite fun. Not many humans have that kind of energy. I probably shouldn't have told him there are secret compartments in the armory, though. He's been looking all day.
What do you think of the rest of the crew?
Dr. Tapero seems nice, if quiet. It must be very different here, compared to the Hyperion. Fewer people in stasis shock.
Let's keep it that way. What do you think of the rest of the crew?
Given Drak's history with Solarians, it's probably better I just stay out of his way. Too bad. That grunion roast he makes smells delicious.
What do you think of the rest of the crew?
I like PB. But I really hope she doesn't lean on the escape pod's manual release by accident.
Is that easy to do?
It's an escape pod. If it's difficult to use, you're doing it wrong.
What do you think of the rest of the crew?
Vetra's very kind.
Yes.
She actually got hold of some dried seaweed snacks for me. Oh. Said I needed feeding up.
I love Vetra.
What do you think of the rest of the crew?
I don't talk to Cora much. She always seems so busy. There are things I'd like to ask her about your father, but it never seems like a good time.
What do you think of the rest of the crew?
No. Oh. If I gossip any more, I'll get in trouble.
No problem. I got you, my dude.
I'll let you concentrate.
You know where I'll be.
Can't spill all of the tea at once. Is this where the thing is? Loadout station. This is where the loadout station is. PB, are you in here? Nope. There's no one in here. Okay. PB, are you in here?
You're setting up in
Yay!
Here, huh?
Yeah, I'm going through what we got out of that vault. If I can crack this data storage box, it'll help with a personal project back on the Nexus. This is a nice, out-of-the-way place where I can tinker, and I can sleep anywhere. It's not exactly homey, but I like that about it. Not really looking for a home. Oh, but I will help you find everyone a home. While I'm with you, at least.
Does your brain ever take a breath?
Sorry, not really. Even my dreams are in time-lapse. I get it. You want to know who's on your ship, so you're here to figure out what makes me tick, right?
Something like that? Sure.
Well, I was born in a log cabin on rural Haitiana, to simple but loving parents, just trying to... I look forward, not back, Ryder. Why snooze through my life story? Get to know me out in the field, while we're uncovering the mysteries of this galaxy. That's why I'm here. Got tired of yawning back home.
Maybe you just needed more sleep.
We were out for 600 years. A special someone made the trip with me, and she woke up a different person. I've slept enough. Ryder, the Milky Way was so... been there, done that. Even if I hadn't done it, someone had. If there's one thing you should know about me, it's that I live for the unknown. For the never been done.
Well, congratulate yourself. No one has ever so successfully dodged my attempts to get to know them.
Yes! I'm number one! Buy me a drink sometime. Who knows what will spill out of my mouth. Then again... I need remnant scrap. Remtech, I call it. For projects like the one I mentioned. Which you're gonna love, by the by. Promise to bring me what you scrounge, and I'll submit to all your questions.
Remtech, huh? You got it.
Girl, I got you a lot of remtech.
You again. Want to hear more about my childhood log cabin?
So, how do you like the team?
Interesting bunch. I get a good feeling from Vetra. Not your typical military-minded Turian. Liam seems a lively one. I expect he'll surprise me. Drak is, well, old. Wonder if he can still learn new tricks.
What about...
Gil smacks of complication. Might take some unraveling. Kallo and Suvi seem busy. I hope they aren't all work, work, work. Who's left?
Well, there's...
Oh, right, Cora. What's her deal? Is she as prim and proper as she comes across?
Oh, is it my turn to talk?
Sorry. Yeah, I should work on my motor.
You might find that people reveal themselves more freely if you give them a chance. Cora included.
Really good advice.
There's also Lexi, our doctor. She's an Asari.
Oh, I'll get around to her. All in all, seems like a decent bunch.
You really won't tell me what you're working on?
That's right. Next question.
Okay.
What was it like for you on the Nexus?
Well, I wasn't supposed to be woken up yet. A resourceful accomplice finagled my early thaw. So I kind of lived off the grid. Snuck around, bullshitted my way onto excursions off station. After I found my first remnant ruin, I started, borrowing shuttles. After that, I didn't spend much time on the Nexus. I even missed most of the revolt.
What drew you to the remnant?
Are you kidding? It's evidence of a sophisticated species no one knows anything about. It doesn't get more intriguing than that. There's so much to discover. I want to be the first to figure them out. And the tech, it's on a different scale. If we can appropriate it, who knows what advances we'll make.
You mentioned you came to Andromeda with someone.
Nothing gets by you. Guess that's why you're the Pathfinder. Just a friend. The one who woke me up early. But now she's not even that. It's better to venture into the unknown without restraints or entanglements, don't you think?
I don't know. Don't friends and loved ones make all the effort worthwhile?
I've always been self-motivated. Don't need much more than curiosity to drive me forward.
I'll leave it to it.
You're off the hook, PB. Good luck with your project.
Thanks. Don't be a stranger.
Do I have remnant tech?
Hey there, got a sec?
Sure.
Nope.
Thanks for chatting. We'll talk again later.
I don't have remnant tech. I swear to God I did. I scanned so much. Bibi, you must understand. Anyway, we finally fucking venture off into this wonderful goddamn galaxy. I'm so done with this fucking planet. It's giving me a headache. Oh, I did the wrong thing.